Hey y'all, it's my review for Basketball Wives, episode 8. I apologize for the delay, but as always, my reviews are worth the wait. But let's get into the episode. So the ladies arrive in Vegas, and before they get to the house, Jackie has arranged a surprise destination for all the ladies. It turns out to be a camel retreat. How random, how pointless. And oh so Jackie, I shouldn't even be surprised. I'm wondering, are they doing this because the Airbnb check-in is until 3 p.m.? Because why would they come off the plane and go directly to the camel retreat? Anyway, they're there for a bit, and we see a private conversation between Malaysia and Angel. And Angel's talking about the drama with Twin One and the whole baby shower meme. I thought they were over this at first, but I forgot Twin One wasn't at Brandy's gathering where Angel was there. Also, what I find interesting about their conversation is, in the last episode, Malaysia was talking to the twins, and she told Twin One to not even bring up the drama on the trip. But she's talking to Angel, and she sees that it's on her mind. So I'm not sure why she didn't tell Angel that she spoke to Twin One already, and that she wanted to apologize. Honestly, it's just a meme. Like, the girl isn't even your friend anymore. Like, why is she so bothered by it? So after the camel activity, the ladies are still on the property for some reason, and they're all seated at this bench table. The topic of the conversation is now Angel and Twin One's beef, which honestly could have just been a private conversation. Twin One actually apologizes to Angel in front of all the ladies, but Angel says she feels it isn't genuine because at her gender reveal, she said when her clown came over that she doubled down on the meme that she posted. Twin One says she did that because she felt ganged up on, and then throws Duffey under the bus by saying that she brought her clown over to the situation when they were arguing, and it just made things worse. Duffey immediately interjects and says the reason why she brought Rockstar over was because she didn't want to upset Angel. You know, she's pregnant, yada, yada, yada. Now that Twin One mentions it, it did make the situation worse. So, I don't know. Who do y'all think is wrong in that situation? I mean, of course, you know, she's wrong for the shady meme, but they definitely made it a thing at Angel's gender reveal. Duffey then calls Twin One's apology fake, and even if it was, like, she did apologize in front of all the ladies. What more do you want from her? Like, what else can she do for y'all to move on? So Duffey and her is going back and forth, and the vibe is really awkward because you have Twin One arguing with the host of the trip. Like, at any moment, I can see Duffey pulling the "this is my trip" card so you can go home. Like, it's coming, I'm sure. Jennifer then steps in the conversation and says after she talked to Twin One, she gathered that she just really wasn't considering Angel's feelings. Now, I'm not sure if she said this to defend her or not. I'm confused. But then Duffey calls Twin One a bitch and is starting to go left. Twin Two is trying to defend her sister now, but I think it's a losing battle for them both because nobody is on their side or speaking up for them. Duffey then leaves the table because she has to go to her gig with French Montana, and Brooke is going with her. But why are the ladies still there? Like, it's nighttime now. Why aren't they at the house? So now you have both twins going into the darkness and Angel following them, and now they're having a conversation. They're trying to explain to her that it's Brooke and Duffey, the ones being mean girls right now, and escalating the situation. Angel seems like she's not even mad anymore about the situation, but she said that she just wants some fucking respect. Angel's man don't even respect her, so it's comical trying to demand respect from somebody else. She the one out here looking crazy, collecting promise rings like Infinity Stones from her clown. Next scene, the ladies finally arrive at their lodging situation, and I'm just convinced that check-in was at 8 p.m. At least the property nice, though. So later on, the topic of the twins is still the focus of conversation. You have Brooke asking Angel what her and the twins were talking about. You have Angel then throwing the twins under the bus, telling Brooke that they said that her, as well as Duffey, are the one being mean girls. And the rest of the ladies think the twins aren't taking accountability. I don't know how Twin 2 got lumped in, but I guess she is. Next scene, we're with Duffey and British, and French Montana makes an appearance. It looks like Duffy's trying to make a connection between British and French. I don't see the appeal of French Montana. I don't even know why he's famous. He has a couple of hits, a couple, and he has just been coasting, and you just see him hanging out with A-listers. I don't get it, but, you know, I'm old now. I don't know what the youngster's listening to. Duffey then tells French her aspirations and asks him on camera, could he record a song with her? Now, I think he doesn't want to embarrass her on camera, so he tells her yes, and she's very excited by this. Meanwhile, back at the Airbnb, the ladies get a FaceTime from Duffey, and she's telling him that she's thinking about disinviting Twin One to her event. The twins coincidentally walk in the room, and Duffey tells him through FaceTime that she thinks it's not a good idea for them to come. She says she doesn't want any bad energy at her gig. Now, I think it's kind of mean to disinvite them at the last minute, no matter what. And plus, it's not like it's an intimate gathering. It's like at a nightclub. So it's not like she's going to have to be around them anyway. So after they're both disinvited and Duffy's off the phone, Twin 2 says, oh, it's mighty quiet. Good observation. Jackie, Malaysia, Jennifer, the ones who actually talk to the twins, don't have no beef with them, they are silent. It's giving very Mean Girls right now, like previous seasons of Basketball Wives when they tried to ice somebody out. Honestly, if I was one of the twins, I would feel some type of way, especially having one-on-one conversation with some of the women. Then when they're in a group setting, they starting to act brand new. Next scene, we're at Duffey's gig with French Montana, and only three of the ladies went. Wow. Like, wasn't that the whole purpose of the trip? Like, I get Angel not going because she's pregnant, but Malaysia didn't go, Jackie didn't go, and Jennifer didn't go. And then she disinvited the twins. What's funny is the twins probably would have went to the event if she didn't disinvite them, because it looked like her real friends didn't bother to go. But in their defense, I will say those Vegas nightclub concerts, they start at 2:30 a.m. and will probably end at 4 or some shit. So they would be out all night. And my old ass, I know I wouldn't be able to hang. So yeah, I probably would have stayed my ass home too. And speaking of that, we see Duffey talking to the ladies after the event, and it is 5:25 a.m. So they were out that entire time. Yeah, no ma'am. I'm not gonna be out there that late. Anywho, she tells the ladies that she was so inspired by this gig that she's decided not to quit DJing. And I'm sure her fiance of 5 years is gonna have a problem with that. And shout out to somebody on Twitter who pointed out that he wants her to quit her job, but doesn't want to marry her. And they've been engaged for 5 years. Make it make sense. Next scene, we're with Malaysia and Jackie in the pool talking about nothing. It's a real best fiends tea. Malaysia's saying that she's having a good time and she's actually warming up to Brandy, and there's probably room for reconciliation. And Jackie is talking about her insecurities with her marriage because her husband Doug is gone all the time with his new job. Fast forward. Next scene, we're in the living room with all the ladies with the exception of Duffey and the twins. The topic of conversation is Jackie opening up to all of them about the insecurities she had in her marriage and how she's missing Doug and how she's alone all the time. This is big for Jackie because she's telling all the ladies her business instead of being in everybody else's. Malaysia gives Jackie some advice, which turns into her addressing Brandy and giving her a genuine apology. Now, I'm sorry, I'm not buying it. I feel like they were acting the entire time, because now all of a sudden Malaysia's in a place to apologize when this could have been happened. Been happened, and they elongated this for 8 weeks. So Brandy just so happened to magically be over it, and then there's tears, there's some hugging. I don't give a fuck. I'm sorry, they wasted our time with this fake beef. Now, if y'all thought the beef between them was real, let me know in the comments. But after the apology, the tears, and the hug, I was like, and scene. I'm just glad that this feud is over, finally. Finally. So after that kumbaya, the twins enter the room, and you can hear a pin drop. Like, nobody says anything. Even the ladies that aren't beefing with them, which makes me think they're being iced out. Duffey coincidentally comes in after, and the ladies speak to her. It seems like she's not even mad at the women who didn't attend her gig. But even where the twins are sitting, we can tell there's a clear divide between them and the cast now. So as Duffey and the ladies are talking about the event, Twin 2 says, well, I'm glad y'all had fun. And then British says, why y'all didn't come out? Twin 2 says, ask Duffey. Turns out after disinviting them, Duffey texts them privately saying they could come out. Duffey cops to it and says she had a change of heart, she felt bad, but the twins didn't go regardless. Twin 2 then asks Duffey, what did I do to you? Duffey doesn't even remember, and then as the twins both trying to remind her, Duffy's like, one at a time, T and Tamara. And here we go. Now, y'all, I know the twins are annoying, but Duffy's being obnoxious right now. She then tells Twin 2 that she didn't disinvite her. She only disinvited one. She literally called her one, like I do. Does Duffy watch the channel? That's pretty specific, but hey, maybe people do call them Twin 1 and Twin 2 or Thing 1 and Thing 2. I don't know. But production shows a flashback of Duffy saying y'all when she was disinviting them, so she did lump Twin 2 along with her sister. So when Duffy's caught in the lie, she says, well, I just assume if y'all were real sisters, one wouldn't go without the other. Because if my sister wasn't invited, I sure as hell wouldn't go. Now, she has a point, but she could have let Twin 2 make that decision instead of making it for her. Duffy then brings up that damn baby shower post again, and then Twin 2 looks like she called out the whole house for being clicky. Which, I agree. Like, it seems like nobody's standing up for them, nobody's saying anything. She was just talking to Malaysia before the trip, saying that, you know, she didn't want any drama, and now Malaysia is silent. She is so fake. That's why I don't really care for Malaysia too much. Beautiful girl, but fake as fuck. Duffy then tells the twins, well, this is my trip, my house, my friends. Y'all are more than welcome to leave. I knew she was gonna do that. If I was the twins, I would have been like, girl, show me the receipts for the private jet as well as the Airbnb. This is VH1's trip, not yours. Also, side note, this scene is heavily edited. Like, you can tell they took so much out. Maybe the twins were breaking the fourth wall because they're talking about the click shit. I gotta say, this is the most vocal I've seen Twin 2 be. Like, at least they ain't never scared. Twin 1 then says, oh boo, I'm staying. I'm gonna put on my swimsuit and enjoy the pool. And then Brooke jumps in and says, oh, y'all just mad because y'all not in the click. And then this is when the back and forth starts. Duffy then calls them a bitch and then walks up on them with Brandy in between them. Now, Duffy, where was this energy for Tammy Roman? That's what I want to know. Because she talking big shit right now. So then as they're yelling back and forth, Duffy takes a styrofoam plate and then throws it at Twin 2. Now, see, Duffy, that's where you lost me. Like, you don't have to throw shit, because when you start throwing shit, everybody gonna start throwing shit. Somebody gonna get hurt. I was kinda with Duffy being angry until she started. She's the one escalating the situation, and it looks like her and Brooke are trying to bully the twins. Like, I wouldn't be mad if one of the twins whipped her ass at this point because she threw shit first. And Brandy is stupid for standing in between them. When shit starts flying, I'm out. That's why they have security on the premises. And speaking of which, here comes security trying to hold the women back, and Brandy's still in the middle of everything. So now it's getting crazy, and it looks like Brooke threw water at one of the twins from the side, and that is when all hell breaks loose. Shit starts flying. You see the twins reaching for glasses. Security is trying to get both of the twins out the house now, but then the twin, she picked up a glass and threw it in Brooke's direction, and it looked like Brandy got hit. All you hear is, oh! But the screen goes black to be continued, and that is where the episode ends. This is the most interesting episode we've had all season, so I was satisfied by this. I would give it I'll give this episode a 7.5 out of 10. I'm being generous. So I enjoyed this episode, but I definitely think I'm on the twin side, shockingly. Duffy didn't have to do all that rah-rah. Like, she made Angel's drama her drama, and Angel should have just accepted the apology and moved on. All that shit was unnecessary, and I wouldn't have mind seeing the twins jump Duffy. But anyway, y'all know I'ma ask whose side y'all on. Y'all let me know in the comments. I'm really disappointed in the ladies that actually were friends with the twins. I'm guessing they were just, you know, being phony. Like, they didn't say anything. And Jackie be the main one being in people's business, but she was silent. That was the most quiet I've seen her. Very mean girl, very cliquish, and I think that's the last time we'll be seeing the twins. Anywho, y'all, make sure y'all like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see y'all for the next episode. Bye!